Heyo, heyo, and welcome to That Manga Club. I am your club president, Cassandra Mangeka, and today's manga was suggested by patron, Dr. Pervert. That manga about a shinigami trapped in a high school girl's body. Of course, I'm talking about Shiro Ihara's only published work, Alice on Deadlines. This manga ran for 4 volumes from March 2005 to May 2006. This manga does not have an anime adaptation, and the manga itself is actually pretty tough to find online. Most sites only have the first 2 volumes. So we're in for a pretty obscure one. Like always, I will be spoiling portions of the manga, but the ending will always be up to you to read. You've been warned. We start off in the Shinigami world, where we are introduced to pervert Shinigami Lapan. He's caught reading a dirty magazine while at work, and he's sent to the section's chief's office as a kind of punishment. He's assigned to reap a corrupt soul known as a Shibito, basically a soul that isn't ready to accept that they died and become violent. Shinigami are forbidden from roaming the human world in their natural form, so they must borrow corpses to inhabit on Earth. Lapan requests a sexy lady's body, but the boss man says, "Nah, I got you a nice skeleton so you can't do any perverted shiz." We cut to an all-girls Catholic school where we meet Alice, a kind and well-endowed girl heading home for the day. She spies a coffin out in the open and approaches it. Then, suddenly, a flash of light. Before her stands, herself. Lapan has accidentally possessed her body, and with her soul with nowhere else to go, she is now stuck in the skeleton meant for Lapan. The school priest appears and scolds Lapan Alice for being out late while there is a supposed serial killer out and about. Lapan runs off carrying Skelly Alice home, but fails to notice that he dropped his assignment papers and passport. In the manga, they call them passage papers. The priest finds them and takes them. While at Alice's home, she elaborates about the killings and that she accidentally witnessed one, which makes her a possible next target. The next day at school, Lapan Alice goes on a skirt-flipping rampage and gropes a bunch of the students. Eventually, Skelly Alice catches up to him, and they run into the priest. Turns out the priest is the Shibito, and it's the Shibito that Lapan was supposed to capture, and the one behind the murders. Dun dun dun! During the epic battle, the passport gets destroyed, and now Lapan is stuck in the human world, which means Alice is stuck in the skeleton. Eventually, the boss notices that Lapan is missing and sends a messenger. They're informed that a new passport is going to take about a year to be reissued, and that they're stuck like this until then. Over the next year, they face various Shibito and mundane schoolgirl problems. Other Shinigami start hanging around too, including a quote-unquote rival that doesn't quite understand what no means. It seems like she was introduced to make Lapan seem a bit more tame. This character is named Ume, and I bring her up because she's treated a bit insensitively in the official translation. This character is also a male Shinigami using a female body, but they're referred to as having a woman's heart and are using the body to win Lapan's affection, as she's in love with him. Some of the terms used show the age of the manga, and I thought I should just give a courtesy warning if you read the official translation. This manga had a lot of potential. I really love the premise, but a few things kept it from being great. The art, for starters, was very flat and stiff. Nothing carried weight, and it suffered from extremely inconsistent hand sizes, which drove me nuts. Look at that! Look how huge! I liked Lapan's design. He was brown and banging, but I found him to be too perverted to be a main character we're supposed to care about. His level of perversion is more reserved for a sparingly seen side character. It caused serious moments to feel forced and a bit out of place. The author tries really hard to force feed you sympathy towards Lapan, but it's hard to take seriously when he's so aggressively perverted. This also caused many of the jokes to fall flat because they're just so constant that they become stale. Which brings me to the writing itself. It's pretty clunky, to be honest. The author did really well with small details that foreshadowed certain events, but the transitions were so jarring that I thought I was skipping pages and it ruined the flow of the manga. And some things in the manga didn't feel organic, more like they happened just because they were supposed to. However, I really enjoyed the world building in this series. I liked the Shinigami world and how it worked, I enjoy the concept that the Shinigami are part of a corporation and death is just business and it's nothing personal. I like the designs of the Shibito. They were gross and interesting, and I also enjoyed Alice as a skeleton. She was adorable and I enjoyed every panel she was in. She tries so hard to make the best out of the situation, and Lupin does not make it easy. Normally at this point I would be talking about the lessons of the manga and what I took away from it, but there wasn't really much of a message. And I think that's the biggest flaw for me. There wasn't a whole lot of character growth, except with Alice, which is probably why I liked her. Maybe the author just intended this manga to be a short, campy, fun experience, but you should always get something out of reading a story. Would I recommend this manga? I mean, at 4 volumes, it's hard to say no. It was entertaining for what it was, but it could have been so much better. And I like it for the potential it has, and the premise was just so good. Like, the premise was so good. And with that, our club meeting comes to a close. Let me know if you've already heard of this manga, and what you thought about it, or if you decided to give it a try for yourself. Thank you guys for watching. If you liked the video, don't forget to hit the thumbs up. If you're new to the channel, don't forget to hit subscribe and ring the bell so you know when I post, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye!